Hey guys, Hobbs here, back in Albion Online. 7 months ago, if you guys remember, I showed you guys an overview of this over three videos. What we looked at was some of the dungeon crawling, the PvP, the PvE, the trades. There's lots of trading in this game, like you can gather materials like stone, and or you can be an herbalist and grab herbs or a leather maker. And there's a huge component of craftsmanship in this game. Well, they've done an update recently, and what I wanted to cover today, because I've got a brand new character and now I'm dungeon crawling and everything else, but I want to let you guys know some of the things that they've changed. First off, the big thing, and by the way, this is another paid sponsorship, so thanks to Albion Online again for this and for considering. They must enjoy the first three that we did. This new update's called Galahad. It's their biggest update, and they do have a ton of features and new stuff that I'm going to cover throughout this video. And also, guys, if you want to try this game out, there is a link in the description below as well. One thing I will show you guys is the inventory. That was the first thing I noticed before I even looked up what other things there was. You'll see there's a lot more stuff. It's a lot easier to read. It just looks a lot more polished, which is a nice feature, but you can actually, you know what I mean, find guild, create guild, everything just looks just, and the other thing that before, after this fight, I'll show you, we're going to go outside actually, just let me get my loots, got to get my loots, no loots, okay. The other thing that I notice is the land is a lot more lush. Like here we're inside a camp, let's see if we can get outside this camp here, guys. A lot of these mobs I had to down on the way in. So those guys, we're going to try not to aggro them, especially two of them. And I like the pathing effects of this. Like you wait for this guy to path down because there's another archer over here, right? Ooh, there. And, you know, you don't want to take too many mobs on, especially if they're higher level than you. But what I notice in this up here, like just in the, even in the starting zone. So those trees there are actually mobs. Stay away. They're two levels higher than me. So I got to stay, but it's a lot more lush. You're going to notice that the map system as well, they just upgraded too, guys. It's a lot more 3D. Like before, it shows you different paths you can take where the next city is. You can scroll way out. You can see where all your boat paths are, so that way you're not guesstimating when you take a boat where you're going. The other thing too is a lot of these zones, they've had it so that you have a good PvE and PvP experience as you're going up throughout the zone. So they've got kind of like, you know, starting areas, starting rewards, but there's still lots of stuff to battle for, and then a mid area, mid rewards. And as you go higher, of course, the loot gets better, the gear gets better, but if you go too high too quick, you're going to get owned. And the other thing too is they put a lot more variety into the cities. The cities now, rather, before, like the city would be very similar, but what they call it is like biome cities. So if you're in the forest, it's going to look more like the forest. If you're in some place like the winter zone, or you're in like big, you know, hills and mountains and stuff, you're going to see a lot more of the environment within, and it's going to blend in a lot smoother. The other thing, as you're going through this and you're farming general mats and stuff like this, and I've restarted a character, so this is a fresh character, guys. But as you're going through and you get higher into it, you can actually fight guardians and stuff like that. And so these guardians are more probably team-based because, I mean, they're going to be huge. And also you're going to get better rewards as you go. So they've done a lot more PvE focus, plus some PvE solo dungeons that they've put focus on that as well, because you don't always want to be in a group or, you know, doing guild stuff. You want stuff that you can do on your own to kind of prove your own worth as it goes, right? Wow, look at this waterfall, guys, as I'm going by it. Like, yeah, they've done a huge rework on it. As we get to the cities too, the one thing I liked was your bank, okay? Your bank is situated in that city. It's not like it's tied into the other banks in the realm. If you want to move those goods to another area, hence those goods might be more valuable in another area, or you just don't want to leave all your possessions behind, you have to bring them with you, which also means that you might get ganked along the way as you get higher leveled, and you may So you may want to party, you know, everybody's like in the guild, hey, I need some assistance. We're traveling. I'm moving goods, you know. Let's just hope your guild doesn't set you up. the joys of online games, eh? Oh, look at this. I've never seen this tree. Of course, dungeons are a huge theme in this game. You're going to be able to go and venture into actual huge story-driven dungeons, you know, end bosses, everything else. Once again, that is going to be required with a guild or even just a really good group. And since crafting is such a huge part of this game, whether you're an armor smith or leather crafter, whatever your role being, that's going to give you a way to make currency in the game. Secondly, though, to barter goods back and forth or to sell your goods, which will help as you get higher, the better quality items get you better quality items, which get you better quality. That's one thing I do like about a lot of these style of games is you get a long-term progression. There's a lot of people playing this game again, guys. Like, a lot of people. So here's that bank I was mentioning earlier. So I haven't dropped anything else in, but as you'll see, the inventory is a lot smoother here. I'm going to drop in some of my goods. Definitely, there's probably a quick key for that. There we go. But take a look at how many people there are. And a lot of people have these like pack mules, eh? And so they're probably doing runs, trying to increase their wealth as they're going. And with these cities, as I covered last time, there's all like different levels of whether it be the Hunter's Lodge or, you know, the lumber mill. So, and it can handle as high of lumber within normally the area, but you got to upgrade your skill as you go on. The city is a lot more 3D, I find, too, than it was before. It's like a whole new game, guys. I'm glad I got a chance to jump in and see it. Throughout this video, I've shown you clips of the trailer, but there are times where my guy actually gets to see it in the full 3D. And of course, you can zoom in, but it depends. Sometimes I like it zoomed out, sometimes zoomed in, depending on where we're going. So we're entering now a yellow PvP zone. Are you sure you wish to proceed? Yes. Maybe. Maybe. Okay, so I've got this bubble on me for a short period as I zone out, and it looks like this is like... Okay, I'm off on my own now. What level are these guys? Level 3. Let's start farming the stuff around here. I need to get my skills up, guys. We gotta get the skills to pay the bills. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Oh my goodness, he got me there. I didn't get out in time. Okay, let's see if I can... If he's got an animation before that floor animation. Oh, my weapon needs repair, guys. It's yellow. Or I just make a new one. Come on, man. Get her done. Get her done. Get her done. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Die. No, I think I need to upgrade my weapons. I might have to go back a little bit. There goes that guy on the horse. But they've also added more spells. So that's going to increase for your PvE and for your PvP. We got to go craft a beginner's broadsword. So I am starting over because like with the beta it reset, but I would say, guys, if you want to give this a shot and with all the new updates, see how far you can progress. The link, like I said, is in the description below. It is a sponsored content, but I only grab the games that I like, and they don't make me say things I don't want to. They're like, you gotta say you love it. Oh my goodness. It honestly, guys, it is so much more busier than it was last time. It was, the name is Hobbs with a Z at the end because somebody already grabbed Hobbs. And this is popular. What's this guy selling? Oh, this is the auction house. I remember doing the auction house. I'm going to leave a link to the two videos or the three videos. I did three videos on this before. So that way you guys can see I covered all this. I covered the dungeon crawling. I covered everything else. I'm just glad to see these updates and what they provided and... Looking forward to progress and figure out what's going on.